Okay, so here we are, part two of attempting to fix the hole in my son's cello. I finally cleared up some space in my phone, and hopefully this video is going to be shorter than the last one. So, let's get the clamps off and see if we can get it all back together. Okay, so here it is. The face is pretty well attached to the rib. I figured out what it was called. It's called the rib. So my children have told me. Now, as far as finishing it goes, we're going to do something quite unconventional. We are just going to clear coat it right over the patch to highlight the patch. So the patch is just wear it like a badge of honor. And which I think is kind of cool. So I'm gonna give it a light sanding and just clear coat it. It can always be finished properly in the future, but I think it'll be kind of fun. Starting out with some 320. This is just so the next coat sticks.
Years later.
I finished sanding with 1500 grit sandpaper. Now I'm gonna put some tape along the edges. Okay, now it's all dusted and taped off. I'm gonna hit it with a few coats of shellac. All right, that's been four coats of paint or varnish. See what we got, or we can see what we got. Just take the plastic off and do any little micro touch-ups that need to be done. Probably gonna sand this with some super high grit sandpaper and buff it. There's a little bit of orange peel on it. Let's see if I can get that to go away. I think that looks pretty cool. Okay, there is this one spot here. It's between the front of the cello, the face, and the rib, where it was broken apart in the first part of part one. and then glued back together. I'm just gonna try and just hide it with some stain. I mean, it's not really that visible, but this one little spot, I'm just gonna try and touch up a little bit. That way it's not so, that way there's not scars all over the cello. And to anyone who's wondering, the clamps are on here just so I can stand it up. It turns out it made it easier to do it this way.